Move on to the Jim Rickards Peter Joseph program, which aired on Thursday, and we got a lot of comments about Peter Joseph's segment. It was awesome. We like him, and we like hearing from him, and we like hearing your comments. So let's play a clip from Peter's segment now.
Starting with the banking system and the financial sector, which I would say is a carcinogenic adaptation of the underlying premise of capitalism, the system itself isn't designed to cater to what we would term technical sustainability or social stability. In other words, you have something called market efficiency, which, as we all know, has to do with the movement of money, the acquisition of efficiency for profit attainment.
Ed, a carcinogenic adaptation of capitalism. I respect and like Peter Joseph. I do have a hard time understanding him. And I mean, you went to the best schools there are. Your vocabulary is just as strong, if not better. Please translate and your thoughts on that actual comment.
Well, I think that he's basically calling it a corporatism, you know. But and a lot of people would agree with him on many levels. Here's the thing is that when he talks about, you know, the carcinogenic
adaptation of capitalism,
you know, he's talking about something that is a maladaptive bolt on to what we originally had. So the question you have to ask is that the way that it's always been? Is that the actual premise?
Right.
You know,
and it goes back to the Malthusian thing as well.
Exactly.
You know, is it another interpretation of that?
I would say that it's not, you know, and you know, basically from my perspective, what Peter Joseph is saying is he's saying that this whole system's corrupt and bad things are going to happen. And not only that, it's completely unsustainable because of this infinite growth model. Now, I can see some of what he's saying, but ultimately there's something Malthusian about it, in my opinion, because, as you were saying, it's just going to
right.
He's saying that it's unsustainable and that the system will collapse as a result
of that. And Justin Templar, this next commenter, he's back again. He agrees with you. Here's what he had to say. He writes, Peter's idea is that companies purposely add inefficiencies to keep things going is utterly stupid. Your competitor will see your inefficiencies and exploit it to take market shares away from you and increase their sales and their profits. Do it on a regular basis and you will find yourself out of business. Ed, what do you think of Peter Joseph's argument in terms of Justin's response?
I agree with what Justin Templar is saying is that it just doesn't make a whole lot of sense. At the end of the day, the real problem is in terms of, you know, so-called shareholder value. The fact that basically, you know, workers are not getting a return, that wages aren't increasing, et cetera. And I think that's really what you're seeing is that workers aren't getting their share.
Sure. Now, we actually have three more comments and a string of comments about Peter, and the other two were positive and in agreement. So I just want to say that. I don't have time to read them, sadly, but we love to have him on. We love starting conversations. So please, thank you for writing in. That's all we have for now, but you can see all segments featured in today's show on YouTube at youtube.com/boombustrt. We also love hearing from you. So please check out our Facebook page at facebook.com/boombustrt. You can also tweet at us at AaronAid, at EdwardNH. From all of us here at Boombust, thank you for watching. Have a great weekend. Ciao.
Bye-bye.